Hello friends, in this video lecture we are going to discuss the introduction to wireless communication. So first we will discuss about the history of the wireless communication. As we know, the first telegraph was invented by the scientist Macaroni in 1896. And the application was the communication by encoding the alphanumeric character in analog signal, and at that time the device has sent the telegraphic signal across the Atlantic Ocean. And then in 1914 the first voice communication device was invented, which is working on the radio waves. Afterwards, in 1960s, the satellite based communication applications started. Again, in advances in wireless technology, the different applications, as we know very well, the radio communication, television signal broadcasting, mobile telephonic kind of communication, and satellite based video signal transmission and reception kind of applications. And more recently, the satellite communication, wireless networking, and cellular technology for mobile phones are available. Now we will discuss the basics of wireless communication. So first of all, the basic question, that is, what is wireless communication? So it is nothing but the transmitting the voice or video signal or any kind of data by using electromagnetic wave in open space, or by using atmosphere or free space, where you will observe the electromagnetic wave will travel at a speed of, you know very well, c is equal to 3 to 10 raised to 8 meter per second, with the frequency and the wavelength. And the formula, you know very well, C is equal to F into lambda. And according to the relation, we can say that high frequency means high energy photons, or indirectly we can say that high frequency indicates high bit rate or high data rate. The higher the energy photon, the more penetrating is the radiation. So if suppose carrier frequency is higher, at that time the penetrating power of the message signal can be improved. Now the different types of wireless communication, these are the examples or categories of the wireless communication. So first one is the point-to-point communication, which is observed in cellular system. So in this diagram or picture, we can able to see the two cell phones are connected with each other. So this is nothing but the point-to-point kind of communication. If suppose one wireless network is there, Wi-Fi network is there, where n number of gadgets or laptops are connected with each other with a single gateway or a wireless node, so at that time we can say that the multi-point kind of communication. So in this picture we can able to see the three laptops are available and they are connected wirelessly by using the single access point. At the right hand side, the next category, that is broadcasting kind of communication, where the broadcasting towers are responsible broadcast the information to the particular radio or any kind of application. Now in this picture we can able to see The radio service, that is walkie-talkie kind of application is there, where the walkie-talkie hand receiver or transmitter is responsible to send the voice signal to the antenna. So this is nothing but the radio service for voice communication. Also, broadcasting communication is observed with the radios, that is AM and FM kind of applications. Then electromagnetic spectrum we know very well. It is divided in N categories with the different frequency bands. So few hertz. So in this diagram we can able to see long radio waves, where the frequency range in the frequency in the range of the few hertz to the few megahertz, and then afterwards we can able to see the AM, FM kind of frequency bands are available, mainly utilized for audio signal transmission and reception purpose, or radio waves which are mainly observed to transmit the audio signals. Then microwave band, which in the range of megahertz to gigahertz. So microwave kind of applications. Then infrared band and in between ultraviolet and infrared band you will find the visible spectrum and its wavelength in the range of 700 in the range of 400 to 700 nanometers. So visible light or visible spectrum. And after this, the frequency range in the range of 10 to 16 you will find the ultraviolet rays or invisible band. So these rays are not visible to the normal eyes. And afterwards you will find the X-rays, gamma rays available with the different wavelengths. So depending on the frequency, that is for long radio wave, AM, FM, microwave, infrared, ultraviolet ray, visible light ray, X-ray and gamma ray, different kinds of applications are available. For example, infrared. So in case of infrared band, you will find the all the gadgets who are working with the infrared light rays. For example, handheld remote controllers. X-rays and gamma rays you will find in the medical applications. So in this way, depending on the application, the different frequency ranges are available. These are the few examples of the wavelengths available with some technologies. So GSM cell phones, where the operating frequency in the range of 900 megahertz to 1800 megahertz. So 1800 megahertz for the dual band cell phones, and wavelength in the range of 33 centimeter. GSM, that is global system for mobile phones. Then PCS phones, personal communication system, the frequency range is about 1.8 gigahertz and wavelength in the range of 17.5 centimeter approximately. Then your Bluetooth technology, whose operating frequency is about 2.4 gigahertz and wavelength in the range wavelength is about 12.5 centimeter. Now about the different electromagnetic carriers, As I said, depending on the application, different carriers are available. So as we discuss, the infrared light rays are mainly utilized in remote controls. So we can say that when the distance between the sender and receiver is short in few meters, for example TV box and remote control, infrared waves are used. And if you are considering the long distance communication or long range communication, for example TV signal broadcasting or cellular or mobile cellular system, so at that time we have to consider both microwave and radio wave. So radio waves are ideal when large area need to be covered and obstacles exist in transmission path, and microwave are good when large area needs to be covered and no obstacle exist in the transmission path. So in both applications, the main intention is to cover maximum distance. And if we are considering the radio wave, so at that time the obstacles are need to consider. Always obstacles are observed in between the two stations. In case of microwaves, the information available with the radio wave get definitely disturbed with the obstacles, but it is slightly disturbed in case of radio waves. So these are the wireless applications or services. So first one is the communication radio, walkie talkie kind of application. Second one is a wireless network. So with the help of access point or wireless node, the n number of devices can communicate with each other, either the cell phones, laptops, computers. Then third one is the cellular phone or smartphones, who are responsible to communicate with each other with the help of the mobile cellular towers. Last one is the short range communication. The applications like the handheld remote control devices, who will communicate with the digital set-top box or television, where the infrared frequency band is mainly utilized. Now we will summarize the advantages and disadvantages. Of the wireless communication system. So first one is the advantages. So mobility is the first advantage of the wireless communication technology, where the wireless devices we can carry anywhere, and these devices will communicate with the another device with the help of the radio wave. One more advantage is that the installation point of view, if you consider, so only single access point or gateway to provide wireless signal is sufficient to provide the wireless network. So if suppose it is not possible to install the cables in hazardous area or in case of long distance based communication system, so at that time we can use this particular wireless technology. Third advantage is that is maintenance point of view, easier to maintenance, because in case of wireless network you will find the single access point or gateway kind of devices who are responsible to provide the Wi-Fi signal or electromagnetic signal to the device like laptop, cell phone or any handheld device. So maintenance point of view, it is easier. Then these are the disadvantages of the wireless communication system.
It has security problems because if suppose the Wi-Fi signals or wireless network is not protected, so at that time anybody can use the Wi-Fi network or wireless network to access the data. Next disadvantage is high cost for setting in infrastructure. So infrastructure and installation point of view, initial investment is more. If somebody want to cover the maximum area of the building or the infrastructure, at that time multiple access points or gateways are need to be installed in that particular area. Next one, unlike the wireless communication, wired communication, wireless communication is influenced by physical obstructions, climatic conditions, interferences from other wireless devices. So most of the time it is observed that the radio waves or Wi-Fi signals get affected due to the environmental effects. Usually in case of rainy season, you will find the variations or fluctuation in the signal. If suppose hilly area is there, rainfall is there, snowfall is there, definitely the radio waves get affected, and due to this reason the information which is available with the radio wave is also get affected. So variations in the information is due to the obstacle and the climatic conditions. One more problem is that interference of the neighboring signal or the another radio signal with the incoming or outgoing electromagnetic wave. So this will happen, the crosstalk kind of problem with the radio wave, and definitely the fluctuation in the information or radio wave. Then in case of wireless network, you will find the word that is channel. So channel is nothing but the carrier frequency of the radio wave. So information from sender to receiver is carrier over a well-defined frequency band. That is, with the help of the specific carrier frequency, the information get transmitted, and that particular frequency band is known as the channel frequency or simply a channel. And each channel has the fixed frequency bandwidth in kilohertz, and capacity is measured in bit rate. The relation is also easier. The maximum carrier frequency will definitely provide you the maximum bit rate, and definitely the data rate of the radio wave is also more. So different frequency bands or channels can be used to transmit the information in parallel and independently. We'll see one example, then the picture get cleared. So in this example, let us assume the spectrum of 90 kilohertz, which is allocated over a base frequency B for communication between station A to station B. That is, for communication between the two stations, that is station A to B, spectrum allocation is, suppose the carrier frequency is 90 kilohertz, and suppose the three channels are available. So assume each channel occupies 30 kilohertz. So that 90 kilohertz get divided in three sub frequencies or channels, that is 30 plus 30, that is 60 plus 30, that is 90. So there are three channels, okay. So 30 plus 30, that is 60. So 60 plus 30, that is 90 kilohertz. So each channel is simplex. In both ways you will find that is simplex or half duplex or full duplex kind of communication. So in case of simplex or half duplex one way communication, you know very well, and in case of full duplex kind of communication, scenario is different. So in case of full duplex, it will use the two different channels, that is front channel and reverse channel. So front channel is mainly utilized to transmit the radio wave or the information to the another station, and the reverse channel is specially utilized or separate channel to receive the signal or receive the information from the another station. So here the time division multiplexing technique is mainly utilized between the two stations. Now according to the picture, we can able to see station A, and in between station A and station B, three channels are there. So channel 1 with the base frequency, that is B plus 30, that is B plus 30. The second channel, the base frequency B plus 30 to B plus 30 plus 30, that is 60, and channel 3, that is B 60 plus 30, in that you will find the B plus 90. So in this way, three different channels are observed in between the two stations, that is station A and station B. So during the communication, maybe the channel 1 is the front channel and channel 2 is the reverse channel. In the next case, maybe the channel 2 is the front channel and channel 3 is the reverse channel, or channel 1 is the front and channel 3 is the reverse, or channel 3 is the front channel or channel 1 the reverse. So depending on the availability of the channel, the station or the system will choose the channel for signal transmission and reception. Now we will discuss about the radio signal or radio wave generation. So basic principle to generate the radio wave. So in this picture we can able to see, if suppose alternating current is given to the copper conductor, and due to the alternating current, the generation of the radio wave, and if we feed that signal to the antenna, so antenna is responsible to transmit the radio wave. So when the high frequency alternating current passes through the copper conductor, it generates the radio wave, which are propagated into the air using the specific kind of antenna. And these are the frequency ranges are mainly observed with the spectrum. So radio waves have different frequencies in the range of 3 hertz to 300 kilohertz. So it is known as the low frequency band. 300 kilohertz to 30 megahertz is high frequency band. 30 megahertz to 300 megahertz, very high frequency, and 300 megahertz to 300 gigahertz will come under the ultra high frequency. So depending on the application or type of the communication, the different frequency bands are mainly utilized. Then about the radio propagation, you know very well the gain factor, loss factor, reflection concept, refraction kind of principle, scattering of the radio wave, absorption. So as far as the gain is concerned, so if suppose the signal get amplified, the peak to peak signal strength get increased. So amplification, gain, loss, or in other word we can say the attenuation in the signal. So in case of wireless network or wireless communication system, also you will find the losses in the radio wave, that is attenuation in the signal. Also you will find the reflection from the reflection due to the surface. Okay, so where the total reflection kind of principle. So in this diagram you can able to see the, this is the incident radio wave and this is the reflected radio wave. So total or 100% reflection. The next one is the refraction. So if suppose one body is there or surface is there, so after the absorption of the radio wave, the radio waves get absorbed by the body and they get refracted through that particular body. So this is nothing but the refraction. And if suppose the radio wave radio waves get bombarded on the rough surface, so at that time you will find the scattering of the electromagnetic or radio wave. So here we can able to see one incident ray on the rough surface, and due to the rough surface the number of secondary waves with the variations in the amplitude and variations in the phase. So this is nothing but the scattering of the radio wave, and as soon as the absorption, where the radio waves get 100% or totally absorbed by the dielectric or any absorbent or the material. So here you will find the attenuation the signal. Then radio waves are generated by an antenna, and they get propagated in all directions as a straight line. This we know very well. And if suppose the long distance communication is there, as the distance increases, here also you will find the attenuation in the signal. So radio wave travel at a velocity of 186 miles per second, and radio waves become weaker as they travel a long distance. That is, if suppose the distance between the two station is so long, so at that time you will find the attenuation in the signal. As the distance increases, attenuation in the signal. So in this diagram we can able to see the attenuated radio wave. Then about the different radio propagation. So different propagation techniques are observed with the radio wave. So first one is the surface mode kind of propagation, where the electromagnetic waves get reflected by the earth surface. Okay, so through the n number of reflections the radio wave will reach the destination or get absorbed by the receiver antenna. The second mode, that is direct mode. So in case of limited distance, you will find the exact line of sight based antenna, where the alignment of the transmitting antenna and the receiving antenna is adjusted such a way that the receiving antenna will receive the powerful signal. So this is nothing but the direct mode. And last one is the ionospheric mode of propagation, where the ionospheric layer, which is observed above the earth surface, is mainly utilized to transmit the radio wave. So in this case the electromagnetic or radio waves get reflected with the help of ionospheric layer, and through the n number of reflections the wave get absorbed or will reach the destination antenna. So these are the three modes of the propagation. Surface mode, so which is observed for the low frequency waves. Direct mode kind of propagation, which is mainly preferred for high frequency waves. And ionospheric mode of the propagation is for the long distance high frequency waves. And this is about the modulation. You know very well, to modulate the signal or the message signal, we require the carrier. So modulation is nothing but adding the information or voice to the carrier electromagnetic or radio signal. So in this picture we can able to see the baseband signal and the carrier signal, and due to the modulation here we can able to see the amplitude. So these are the two basic modulation techniques. So in these waveforms we can able to see, the first waveform is the baseband signal or information. Second one is the amplitude modulation. Now in this case the amplitude of the carrier make a change in coordination with the baseband signal. And about the frequency modulation, now in case of frequency, the frequency of the carrier get change in coordination with the baseband or information signal. So in this way different modulation schemes are also observed with the wireless communication, that is ASK, FSK, QPSK, QAM. So different modulation techniques are mean utilized to transmit the information with the help of different modulation schemes. Then radio frequency interference, as we discussed a few minutes before, the radio wave or electromagnetic wave get disturbed with the help of different propagation problems like scattering, reflection, diffraction kind of mechanisms, and due to this reason the electromagnetic or radio wave get disturbed or get distorted, and due to the distortions in the signal the information available with the radio signal is also distorted. So in this diagram we can able to see the interruption or the glitches in the signal due to the mixing of the another radio wave, or due to the number of reflections, or due to the scattered waves. And the signal degradation, as I said, as the distance between the two stations is more, so at that time you will find the signal degradation. So we can say that as the distance increases, attenuation in the signal. So signal degradation or attenuation is also observed with the radio wave. So this concept is known as the radio signal attenuation, that is path loss. So in this diagram we can able to see at the left hand side the strong radio wave, and if that strong wave get passed to the medium. Now as we are discussing about the wireless communication, so in case of wireless communication you will find the free space or the environment, and due to the environmental effects you will find the variation in the signal, and the attenuation is due to the environmental parameters. So distance is need to consider to the path loss. So as the distance increases, attenuation in the signal. So n number of parameters are need to consider under this medium, and at the right hand side we can able to see the weak electromagnetic wave. So initially near the transmitting station you will find the powerful signal, and as the receiver goes away from the transmitting antenna, the signal quality or the signal strength get reduced, and this is nothing but the path loss problem in the radio wave. So we will stop here. In the next lecture we will discuss about the large scale path loss and different propagation methodologies.